Mary told Joseph, but he didn't really understand. God sent an angel to Joseph as he slept. He told him not to be afraid. So Mary and Joseph got married just as they had planned. Emperor Augustus Caesar ordered a census, which meant that everyone had to go back to where they were born to be counted.
Since Joseph was born in Bethlehem, Mary and Joseph had to go on a long journey, which was not easy with a baby on the way.
Even with the trusty donkey to help, it took them a long time to reach Bethlehem.
It seemed as if everyone had got there before them. They tried and tried, but they could not find a place to stay. Mary was so relieved that she could
hillside outside Bethlehem. Some shepherds were watching over their sheep. They made sure the sheep didn't wander off.
Tonight, a saviour has been born. You'll find him in a stable, lying in a manger.
At that moment, the sky was filled with angels singing.
Everywhere the shepherds looked, they could see angels sing.
Glory to God and peace to all people on earth.
As soon as they found Jesus, just as the angels had said, they fell to their knees and praised God.
When they reached Jerusalem, King Herod summoned them to meet him. He had heard their stories about this baby who would be king of the Jews, and he was not one bit pleased. He did not want another king on his path.
However, in front of the wise men, he acted like he was excited.
King Herod asked the wise men to come home and let him know where the baby was so he could go and visit.
The wise men agreed and settled from the start.
They couldn't believe their eyes when the star stopped. angel of all the animals to guard the baby Jesus and Mary and Joseph to look after him.
They presented their gifts to Jesus.
They bought gold to show they respect as him as a king.
They brought myrrh to show respect for the times he would suffer during his life on earth.
Remember this story every year to remind us that God sent his Son to bring us love and peace.
We pray that we can bring love and peace to everyone we